Welcome to Dan and Meg Outdoors and another video. A bit different today, not doing a camp, so if it's a camping video you were after, you better go and have a look at something else. It's not this video. On the back of last week's wild camp on the Long Mynd, you know, you may remember my scarf one had torn, so obviously I lost a bit of confidence in that. I've got a repair patch kit being sent out to me from Tarp Tent. I'm waiting for it to arrive. So on the back of that and a little bit of a lack of confidence, I've gone out and bought another new tent, which I'm going to show you today, which is the Terra Nova Pioneer 2. In all fairness, before I bought my Scarp 1, this was actually my first choice, but I got a little bit impatient because Terra Nova happily advised me that they didn't have any in stock until the spring, so me being impatient, I went out and bought Scarp 1 anyway. So what I'm going to do, it's obviously not, it's not going to be a review because I haven't camped in it yet, so it's just a little first look, see how easy it is to pitch. So if you're in the market looking for a new tent, it might give you an idea. So anyway, I'm just going to get this up now and I'll give you a nice show around. See you in a minute. Probably the biggest faff of a tent I've ever put up, so but I've managed to do it. But I tell you what, if it was pouring down me rain, I'd have been saturated by now. But let me give you a quick walk around. Anyway, I'm going to take you inside, show you features. Nice Dyneema line lock there. I have to say, I do like the way the roof area clips on. Good quality, and if you lift that up, you've got air vents there, and you've got another one just over the other side there. Clips on nicely, look at that. Can do it with one hand, that's it. So yeah, Pioneer 2. I have to say the tent pegs are of a very, very good quality as well. I can't quite remember what the weight is per peg. Very lightweight, aluminium. I'm not sure whether you'd actually describe them as X shape or Y shape, star shape. They give you 12 pegs with this tent. Obviously I haven't got it fully guided out because this is just like a first look. But one thing I do really like about this tent, it practically goes to the floor. Look at that. I mean, it's not the best pitch, it's my first attempt. So we just go down right to the floor. So anyway, I'm going to open the doors and I'm going to take you inside and we'll go through the sizes and stuff like that in there. So, oh yeah, one thing I need to mention before I forget. When you're pitching this tent, it's all colour-coded, so you've got a red pipe there. Obviously, you've got the blue there. If you look at the toggles at the bottom there, that'll correspond with the blue pole. So anyway, I'm going to open the door and I'll give you a quick look round on the inside in just a moment. seriously good quality material. Seriously good quality. The zips. No catching on the zips. Fantastic. Another nice little feature that comes with this tent as well. To give you one of those. So instead of having it all flapping round, click it on there, get it out of the way, nice. And another thing you'll notice with this tent, look at the with the ground sheet now. Covers the vestibule area. Nice, impressive. So you've got to worry about, you know, you could actually sit on that. Right, let's have a look inside. Moment of truth. One thing I've just noticed as well, don't forget, this is my first pitch. There's a little toggle on the bottom here. You have to, there's a band, a tension band. What you need to do more faff. But anyway, let me open it up and we'll see what it looks like on the inside. So one thing you'll notice when you come into this is the quality of the foot of the ground shape, well, the floor of the tent. Feels like a seriously good quality. Another nice little feature on this tent, if you let me show you. Once you've undone the tent, undone the inner, just get that in your hand, pack it away. I mean, obviously it's not the best pitch, it's not particularly tight. It's actually quite loose in here, which I'm quite surprised about. Because I couldn't possibly have pulled the fly sheet out any tighter, but obviously with a few more pitches I'll probably be able to get it a little bit better. It just looks really loose and saggy inside, which I can't say I'm particularly blown away with. But there's a nice gap there in between the fly and the inner. Mesh on the top half for ventilation. Mesh there, mesh up there. Mesh all around here, two pockets. Yeah, they are the only two pockets in here, but you do have a bit more, you have loads of space. That's actually quite a big pocket, this one here. So let's have a look. I'm not the biggest person, the tallest, but I'll see how we got on with height for you tall folk. Right, I'm gonna put my feet right to the bottom, literally right to the bottom. So if I lie down in here now, I'm 5'8". I would say I've got another 12 inches above my head. So if you're 6'8", you're laughing with this tent. But it will stretch out a bit more. Obviously, once you've tightened it all out, you'll be able to manage it. I think you could possibly get to, I mean, it is a two-man tent, and to be fair, thinking about it now, looking at it, you could quite easily get two sleeping mats in here if they're a regular size. But I'm amazed at how long this thing is. It doesn't look long from the outside, but on the inside it's actually quite big. But I do need to get a bit of practice in to tension, tighten it all up inside this. So anyway, the stats for this tent are the hydrostatic head is 5,000. The flooring on this tent is 10,000. So that's more than capable for any of the weather that the UK could throw at it rain-wise, unless you're sitting in a river. Very, very waterproof. Looking at some of the stitching's a very good quality, but I wouldn't expect anything else from Terra Nova. Very good quality stitching everywhere. I'm not quite sure what the flooring head on it would be, along as well with the separate ground sheet which came with it. But yeah, you'd get a very generous sized vestibule on this side. And if you just let me open the other door, see the other, as you'll notice, this door here, the main door here, this opens up a completely different way, and the pocket, the door is kind of on the side, so you can literally tuck that away nicely. With this one, there's just a small toggle here, see the little toggles there, which you can, this door you have to roll up yourself, rather than just fold it in. It'd have been nice if they'd have put another little pocket in there, just to put that in, just a nice little touch. You just hook this up in there. And I'll open this door here. Oh, another thing to mention as well, it's double zipped. So you've got that zip all the way down to the bottom down there. It's pouring down with rain. You can have this door, you can have the zip open like that as well. But there's one thing you'll notice, if you haven't already, you only get one, the vestibule on this side is practically non-existent. Again, looking for the clip to clip this back on to the pole, just like that. So yeah, obviously it's tightening out on the inside because it is very, very loose. But I'm assuming what I'll need to do with the bungee you get there for the ground sheet and the inner tent, there's two. You obviously put a couple of twists in that just to tighten it up inside. So yeah, so just to give you an idea, a full idea of the length and the width, let me just show you. Out comes the magic measuring tape. Megan's holding the camera for me. Right. If you want to come in here with me, Meg. Oh. The width at the most widest point of the inner is exactly 1 meter, literally exactly. Megan, if you want to shine the camera down there on the tape measure so you can see, there's the 1 meter mark there with the seam seal. Now, lengthwise, for all you tall folk out there, that will go a bit further. No, it won't. Just over 2 meters. There's a 2 meter mark there, if you can have a look, if you can see it. So it's exactly 81 inches in length. You'll have to do the sums on that, convert that into meters, feet. I'd probably say, well, 2 meters. So it'll be perfectly fine for taller people. And at the narrowest point, which it's looking like the narrowest point anyway, because it's not pulled down properly. For measuring the narrowest point of this tent, you're looking at 3 foot on the narrowest part of the tent. So yeah, there you have it. But if I can just get out, if Megan will move out of my way. She's a camera girl today.
I am.
So overall, apart from the faff and Megan not holding the camera to me, apart from the faff, overall first impressions, it's a good, seriously good quality tent. I mean, the stitching's absolutely bang on. Material feels nice. Let me just go and show you these pegs. I'll get one. They actually give you more pegs than you need. And obviously, I obviously haven't got it all guided out properly because I don't need to. These pegs barely weigh anything. Got the nice Terra Nova written on it. So yeah, very lightweight. They weighed absolutely nothing. They're probably as light as my tarp tent pegs. Really, really lightweight. So, but the overall weight of this tent without the without the footprints is 1.9, 1.8, 1.9, and with the footprints it works out at 2.1. So not the most lightest tent you're going to use, but it's nowhere near the heaviest. So, but yeah, overall impressions, I'm looking forward to going out in this, give it a good test. I've lost a lot of confidence in my my scarf, so there stands a chance I could be considering moving it on. So, but this was obviously my first choice anyway. So yeah, if you've got any questions, if there's anything you're unsure about, if anybody knows how to pitch this tent with minimum fuss, because I had an absolute bloody nightmare, then I'm all ears, mate. I'm literally all ears, because that was a nightmare. So yeah, but if you've liked this video, give us a thumbs up. If you don't, thumbs down. And if camping, wild camping, outdoor adventures, hiking, getting to the mountains is your thing, or even woodland, then obviously you're in the right place. So thumbs up, hit the subscribe button down there. We've got a wonderful selection of videos on the channel now, so it'd be great to hear your comments. And obviously, if anybody can give me a hand on easier ways to pitch this machine, then I'm all ears. So from Dan and Meg Outdoors,
see ya. See you soon.
We'll see you very soon.
Yep.
Bye.
Bye.